The first of two CNC machines has rocked up at the office. We made the decision about a year ago to have these machines in-house to basically do it ourselves. These machines fit the bill. They're very high-end, aerospace-grade machines, which can produce parts of very, very high quality. They can also produce parts very, very fast as well. The two machines can do a vast majority of the stuff we've been prototyping overseas and with local suppliers for the last 8 to 10 years. This machine's the first machine, which is a Y-axis lathe, basically a 4-axis milling machine, as well as being a lathe. It's a big job, these installations. We've had to clear this whole workshop. We moved that all next door. This now will be our clean space for the two CNC machines, as well as the electronics pick and place prototyping line. The truck rocked up this morning. It was a pretty big truck. It was a big crate and had to have a 40-ton crane that was taking it off. The guys from Edge Engineering saw a gap in the weather, decided to go for it. We were originally going to put the crate into the other workshop and take the roof off it and then find a gap in the weather to basically move the machine. But they ended up doing it all outside, which was ballsy. We ended up moving the machine just in time with sort of like 30 seconds before a hailstorm came through and wet the guys. This is Jim from Edge Engineering. He's come to basically rig and lift into place, install and calibrate.
Basically, yeah. We've been involved with DMG MORI as their service agents. So we look after service and support. The machine rocks up, we commission it, and any issues you have, we just come out and fix it for you.
What are you doing now? You're getting in position and leveling it.
Yep.
And then getting it ready to power up.
We've leveled the base and two planes. Got it pretty close to 20 micron over a meter. Put the chip conveyor in. We're about setting your bar feeder up, ready to go. And then the centers of spark is you've got power. We can turn it on, run the spindle up, check all the alignments, and basically hand it over for your training.
You do many of these?
Yeah, we've probably done 12 in the last 18 months.
Nice.
Yeah, from NLXs up to the DMU 50, like you're getting pretty busy with it all.
And you're coming back next month?
That's it, mate. The next one, the big one.
Yeah. And it's one of those things with these machines where you always kind of dream of having them. To go through like a year of spreadsheets and business plans instead of taking the easy route, which was to keep offshoring stuff or deal with local suppliers. Most of the time they're very busy. We've already got jobs that we've kind of put off sending to other suppliers because we wanted to put them on our own machines. It's a conscious choice to have these machines here. And the main payoff is that the guys doing design get that instant feedback from the machine operator. They actually know we need to change the design here so it's more accessible for the tool, or it's quicker to machine, or decrease cost. That's already been realized without the machines even running. And I think it's just going to get better and better. Pretty excited.